Let's welcome today. In the previous video we discussed about how to calculate the CPA and CGPA for the regular students. Regular students means the students who did not have any backlog in his career. Today we'll look into the candidates who have two backlogs, three backlogs. For such students I made this particular video. Okay, we'll start with the actual. What do you mean by grade points? How we should give the grade points? So grade points depends upon the total marks. The total marks means it's a sum of CIE, continuous internal evaluation marks plus external marks. So based on the total marks, we assign or we allot the grade points. Letter grade and corresponding grade points in a typical 10-point scheme. Here we are having some letters, so which will indicate some grades. S, A, B, C, D, E, F. These are the letters which indicate grades. With respect to the grade points, if F is a grade, that point is 0. If the candidate is failed, so that should be given by the grade point 0. Similarly, for grade E, 0, 4. Grade point is 4. For grade D, grade point is 6. For the grade C, grade point is 7. For the grade B, grade point is 8. For the grade A, grade point is 9. For the grade S, the grade point is 10. Okay. Here, so what will be the range of these grade letters or letter grade? So the rubrics of those grades are given here. S means outstanding, A means excellent, B means very good, C means good, D means above average, E means average, and F means fail. So already we knew the grade points related to the grade letter. Here the percentage of marks scored in a course. If the score is between 90 to 100 for a particular course, that grade is S, its point is 10. Similarly, if the percentage marks scored in a particular course is between 80 to 89, its grade is A. 70 to 79, B. 60 to 69, C. 45 to 59, D. 40 to 44, E. 0 to 39, F. So here the minimum passing marks is 40 out of 100. So that's why if the score got less than 40, so that is what failed. So computation of SGPA and CGPA, already we discussed these things in the previous videos. So following expressions shall be used to compute the semester grade points average, that is SGPA, and cumulative grade point average CGPA respectively. SGPA means the sum of the product of course credits and grade points for all the courses in that semester divided by the summation of course of credits for all the courses in that semester. Already we looked into this particular formula in the previous video. So this also we will explain in briefly. CGPA means it's a cumulative grade point average, that is sum of course credits into grade points for all the courses. This point is very important, excluding those with F grades until that semester. CGPA means cumulative. So if you want to calculate CGPA, you should at least have two semester, minimum two semester. It can't be calculated for the single semester. So excluding those with the F grades until that semester divided by summation of course credits for all the courses excluding those with the F grades until that semester. This is what CGPA. This formula is very important. SGPA is common formula. While calculating CGPA, you just look into F grade, excluding F grades until that semester. The SGPA and CGPA shall be rounded up to the two decimal points and report in the grade cards. Okay. So here I'll take one illustration. An example I have taken here. Semester odd 1 and even 2 means to calculate SGPA and CGPA, we should have at least to calculate CGPA, we should have at least two semesters. That's why I take an odd 1 and even semester, first semester and second semester. Okay, these are the different course codes 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. We are having 6 subjects here. Those grades are here 5, 0, 0. These are the teaching hours, including theory and practical. Those grades are 5. For this particular course, these are credits given 5, 5, 3, 2, 5, 5. The total credits are 5 plus 5, 10 plus 13, the 13 plus 15, 20, 25. So 25 is the total credits of that particular odd semester. Grade, these are the grades already explained in the previous slide. So next, grade points. For the different grades, you are having a different grade points. For fail, the grade point is 0. Okay, these are the already explained. Credit points. CR into PR means that it's a product of credits into grade point. 5 into 8, 40. 5 into 0, 0 because the grade point is 0. 3 into 9, 27. 2 into 0, 0. 5 into 6, 30. 5 into 4, 20. So these are the credit points, means the product of credits into grades. If you add all these, we'll get the summation of credits into grade points for all the courses for the particular semester. Here, semester 1, the total is 117. Its credits are 25. So what is the SCPA formula? SCPA formula is the summation of credit points into grade points. Credits into grade points of all the courses divided by sum of the credits of that particular semester. Means 117 divided by 25. We'll get a SCPA for the particular semester 1. This is in general. But while calculating CGPA, you should understand that the sum of credits into grade points of all those of that particular semester, excluding those with the excluding F grades of that particular or until that semester. Here we are having two subjects are fail. One is absent, that is what it says is 5. And next here we are having one more subject that is failed. 2, it's credits 2. So 5 plus 2. So 7 out of 25, will subtract 7. So we'll left with 18. So we'll 18 as a star marks. So in this particular semester, we'll take in 18 as a star marks. Means while calculating CGPA, this 18 should be taken into account. Okay, you should understand that it's a total credits into grade points is 117. Total credits are 25 to calculate the CGPA, but 18 it will help you to calculate the CGPA because we should not include failed grades. This is for first semester. The products of credits into grade points are given here. So 5 into 7, 35. 4 into 8, 32. 3 into 6, 18. 5 into 4, 20. 4 into 9, 36. 2 into 0, 0. 2 into 8, 16. These are the regular semester, regular second semester subject. But in the previous first semester, we failed two subjects. If you want to pass that particular subject in the second semester, if the candidate writes those failed subject in the second semester, we'll also include that in while calculating the SCPA and CGPA. Because those failed subjects are this one, having a credits of 5 and 2. So it's grade point 6-7. So 5 into 6, 30. 2 into 7, 14. If you add all these credits, these are the credits of the regular semester second. These are the failed subject, but you should add these also while calculating the SCPA. So 5 plus 4, 9, 12, 17, 21, 25, 30, 32. 32 is important for calculating the SCPA. 30 because again the candidate is failed in one. So here the candidate is failed, its credits is 2. Subtract 2 from the whole credits. So 30 star. The 30 star will help you to calculate the CGPA. Okay, SCPA means total add this one, 35 plus 32, 18, 20, 36, 0, 16, 30, 14. It becomes 201. So SCPA equal to the sum of credits into grade points of all the courses divided by the sum of the all the credits. Means 201 divided by 32. We'll get 6.28. This is SCPA of the second semester. So if you want to calculate the CGPA of the first semester, second semester, because CGPA itself indicates it's a cumulative grade point of your average. So in the first semester, you were having 117 as a SCPA, so total credits into grade points. In the second semester, you were having 201 credits into grade points divided by, so the sum of the credits of all the courses excluding the F grade, excluding F grade. In the previous first semester, you were having 18 as a credits points excluding grade F. Similarly, you are having 30 here also. So 30 plus 18, 48, 318 by 48 will give you the CGPA of the semester 1 and semester 2. The formula is very important. Course credits into grade points of all the courses excluding those with the F grades until that semester divided by F summation of course credits for all the courses excluding those with the F grades until that semester. So the failed subject that help you to calculate the CGPA. SCPA is common. Okay, this is a formula to calculate the CGPA. So if you want any clarification with respect to this, again watch this video again and again, so you'll have a certain idea with respect to how to calculate the SCPA and CGPA for the backlog students. So please subscribe and save as much as possible, please do subscribe. Thank you very much.